and most handsome improv troupe.
Yeah!
We have two girls that are still handsome as hell. So, let's go down the line. Everyone introduce yourselves.
My name is Ned.
I'm Kata Yu.
Comedy is where we're going to get a random input from you guys, do a little word association. Then we're going to do hotspot monologues, telling some stories about our lives. Then we're going to do three unrelated scenes. Then we're going to do some long-form comedy off those scenes. So, we got the loaf down here. You guys know how to, these guys are from Shenandoah, everyone?
Yeah! Give them a hand. Yeah.
Right? When I say bare feet, what do you think?
Foot.
Hair. Hair. Shoes. Shoes.
Toenail.
Smell.
Beach.
Bunions.
Dead.
I don't want to know your life.
People.
Ground.
Animals.
Socks.
Say first thing that comes to mind. Socks.
Shoes.
Twerking.
Yeah. Ah, damn. Twerking.
We're gonna go with what's a falafel.
Yeah!
I have to be honest, I did not know what a falafel was until last year when my friend had to go on the computer, go on Wikipedia, and show me what a falafel was. I thought it was a waffle.
When I was in Copenhagen, there was one Turkish dude who worked at a stand as big as himself, and he made kebabs. It was called kebabenhaven, which was a Danish pun.
I had really bad luck with kebabs when I was in kindergarten. We had kebab day for whatever reason, and I managed to stab myself in every single one of my fingers and my tongue. I don't know where they kept it.
One time during like a summer camp thing, I got in a marker fight with another kid. He was red, black, green, some pink, some yellow.
So this is art class, and I'm like, hey, friend, cut my paper, and like he just cuts like in through my fingers.
My first and last art class in high school, my teacher told me, draw something but in a different color. So I did a bright yellow Chewbacca, and she said no and ripped it in front of the whole class. Look at what Doug did.
There's a scene at the end of the movie The Avengers where they decide that they want to go and get falafels. It was not actually included in the original movie, but it's a really adorable scene, and if you believe it,
When I saw the Avengers for the second time on a plane when I was going over to Germany, and I was in the most awkward position because the person just would not put their seat up.
I know the movie Who Framed Roger Rabbit by heart because on the 11-hour flight to Hawaii, it was the only in-flight movie.
I watched Project X on a flight from Ghana to New York, and that's the weirdest movie to watch on a plane, I think.
I fell asleep on a plane watching whatever, but I woke up, the stewardess put orange juice in front of me, and it spilled everywhere.
I almost got my mom arrested by the TSA at an airport when they asked me what her name was, and I thought it was a joke, so I said Amadeus, and I can't do that. This was my senior year of high school.
There was only one time I ran from the cops, and I was at Acme, and we had one girl with us and seven dudes, so we're like, let's get the most awkward assortment of things that these people are gonna see. So we got like that chocolate that hardens on top of ice cream, and then we got like a dog leash, and then we got like some other random stuff, and then we decided to take the what are they called? The shopping carts that you ride around like a motor scooter? I think the Italians ride them around normally.
At the grocery store when I was a kid, I always loved to ride around in those little carts that were shaped like buses, except I was this height when I was in sixth grade, so I never really fit into them, so I would always be like pulling the cart down in front. My parents would get so pissed off at me. It's another story.
Sweet.
Thanks.
Marker fight.
Ah! It's red. Brandon.
I got the kebab, but where's
Hold
the bus?
This is a finger kebab.
Look, you
the blood really adds some flavor.
Does it?
Well, you got your tongue now. That's even better. We're having a fun time at the worst kindergarten ever.
So, Katayoon Amir Aslani, we're gonna have to randomly select
Kebab Palace. Now, as you'll see, there are many little critters running around, maybe some bigger critters. Here's your kebab, nice and big, nice and big. Anything you spear, you can eat. Have one. Okay, you see, right over there. That's a beef.
I can't do it, man. I can't do it.
I don't think you can do it. You're hungry, right? You are hungry. I can tell you right now, they're all sharp.
I have kids, man.
That every single time.
Does this work, kids?
I swear he only had kids so he could make that excuse.
Sweet!
So, you're getting ready for your nap time?
I've been watching this movie for 11 hours.
Chloroform? Here's your rock. Because you're going to need to hear this terrible, terrible story that'll make you sad. And then he died.
Sweet!
Hey man, so I stole one of those moped Italian scooters and I put a bus on the front.
Yeah!
You ready to go shopping?
Yeah! Come on!
We can go at like 15 miles an hour.
What's you're up? Way too big.
Well, yeah.
Hey guys! Hey, got this place?
Yo, shorts, man, get in!
Later, tall bitch.
So I think our markerfights could be genuinely improved if we just stack them on like this.
See, I just have this row of markers that I was just going to sharpen at my grinder.
You're taking this too far, man. This is way too far.
This marker is fake.
I'm six. What is going on? Different scene. So I am going to need four inputs. And for these guys, can I get a burp? Burp, just any burp.
Running.
Spunk.
Working.
Oh my god.
Working. No, not
Bow wow.
Okay, ready?
In the doctor's office.
Rotate that.
Melancholy.
Rotate that.
Score.
Two score.
Rotate that.
Conjugate.
Bow wow.
Okay. Rotate right. What are you guys?
Score. Two score.
Lights.
What?
Did you remember to take out the trash?
No, Roger, I didn't.
William Loaf is terrible.
Rotate.
Right.
You want to show me this melancholy? I know a guy. He drew a little picture of a collie on the belly. It was like,
rotate right.
Hey doc, so I got this problem, and I know my insurance covers it because it's a twerk related accident. You're just gonna have to.
Rotate right.
I got this new thing. You heard the ShamWow? Now try the Bow Wow.
That's just, it's my dog.
That is the best dog since Old Yeller.
What did you wash with him?
Oh, I washed many things.
Is this your vomit?
It's his vomit. He got all excited when I was talking about it. Your sister called.
Yo, what that bitch said.
She and Henry are going down to the lake. The lake.
The lake.
Rotate left.
He's crying.
Oh, he's bow wowing.
Rotate left.
Steve, are you?
Yeah, so,
is it still in there?
No. There's nothing in there. I think you just wanted me to look at your butt.
You found me out,
all these years.
It's a very nice butt, but I have real patients with real problems.
Rotate left.
Smelling color is made out of real border collar.
That's right, you drew a picture of a melon on a collar.
So special Olympics. What we have for you guys are two Olympians who will be competing in an event of some kind, something very physical, but they'll be doing it in slow motion for you so that you guys can see everything. We also have two commentators who will be telling you everything that is going on just to make sure that we're all clear. But this is the not so special Olympics, so it's not something you would see in ordinary Olympics. What we need is as something that you would do in your mundane, average, ordinary life, basically.
Tea party! Roommate! Watch Game of Thrones!
Build a barrel.
Go to the play apples to apples!
Science twerking!
Wall of
science twerking!
Think about it!
Wallow and self-tune.
Wallow and self-tune. Close it off.
Hang in there.
All sleep in glass.
Only a sleeping glass.
Right. The event that they are going to be competing in is pumping gas.
Lights up. Well, welcome to Not So Special Pumping Gas Olympics. I am your host, Jack Danger.
I'm James Vanderbilt.
Being from New Jersey, I've never pumped gas before in my life, so this is terrible. What can we expect to see from our Olympians today?
Well, I'm from New York, and we like to get off our lazy butts.
Hello.
Today, our first event, our competitors are going to fight for the last open gas pump.
Sounds very tense. Now, what the competitors do not know is that a small fire has been started somewhere in the gas pump. And begin! Now, Doug's truck seems to be a little bit shit, and this could be a problem.
Victoria's got the sports car going, and she is riding fast. She better be careful.
He's ignited the gas. The fire has started. They only have about 5 minutes, so the entire place goes up in smoke.
What?
She's now exited the car and started spraying with gas. What? She's on fire! This is getting very dangerous. Using his fire-bending abilities, apparently. It's her face is just melted completely. Find the pump in time.
He's got found it. He's got the pump.
He just picked up the entire pump.
Where is his car?
His car is caught on fire. This seems hopeless. Can he salvage it in the 11th hour? He's spitting the gas into the tank. It seemed to work. Doug is the winner. Very few competitors can make this with their lunch intact. They have to visit the gas station bathroom. They will have to wade through an ocean of fecal matter and find the crocodile.
I've seen Doug attempt this before. It did not go well.
The crocodile took his ear. He hopes to win it back today. And
surprise.
Begin! I started this event rather constipated. It looks like they may already shat her pants. Doug has lost his lunch. That's an automatic 3-point deduction. Let's see if he can salvage it.
He's opened the door.
He's now going through. And she's attempting to drown him in the feces. Steve Irwin would be proud.
She's turned that around.
It's taken his other ear. Can she make it to the bathroom though? From her pocket Alexis I put into her Gatorade, she needs only 10 seconds left before it all goes to shit. He's made a boat out
he's
of
made a boat.
Toilet paper. And she's fallen straight into the toilet and shit her pants. I think that counts. It landed in. Karina is the winner.
Yeah!
Look at the respect, the sportsmanship. Doug is bleeding everywhere.
Am I really?
Your ears are gone, Doug.
What'd you say?
A favorite of mine, driving away without paying. Now, they are going to be pursued not only by the police, but by the military. There is a predator drone circling ahead.
Does the military have a weaponized crocodile here?
Is the Pope Catholic?
And it begins!
Ah, they've switched to motorcycles for this event. Using her tricycle, very good. Crocodiles raining from the sky. We need to work together to survive this onslaught.
Oh,
oh, oh, oh,
no.
He's
Doug says dodge this.
Dodge. And she did.
And Doug has taken a crocodile. Right to the another one to the tuchus. He's
alive. He doesn't even know what his
tuchus is. She's the pumping yes champion.
Okay, this next game is called Dr. Know-It-All, and we have Dr. Know-It-All here, and he knows all, and it knows all. You, if you have questions, please raise your hand so that Dr. Know-It-All can answer for you. Anyone? Questions?
Oh.
You, girl with the glasses. Sorry.
Brant, you're a boy, remember. Something which we'll find out in a bit. What he doesn't know is that James has an evil twin named George. And George likes to sneak into the room and be James and mess things up. And James has to switch back and explain why he did that. So, what I need is a non-familial relationship, as in not in your family.
Wizard and apprentice.
Oh,
at least.
Fraternity, bro.
No
not a victim. Romance. Dog a cat. Mistress. Dog a cat.
SpongeBob man, that guy is just a hand. Cat and mouse.
Donkey and horse.
Working.
Like a farmer and like a talking donkey.
The king and the man with the
king. Hero and sidekick.
President and vice president.
You guys are hero and sidekick.
Oh, yeah!
Hero and sidekick, evil twin, lights up.
So, hi. Are you the candidate for new adventure boy?
Yeah, I mean, I think I could really do well, and I really want to help the citizens.
See, a lot of times people are like, oh, I think I can do well, but one thing to do is to prove it. So if you could eat this whole jar of hot sauce, then you're out.
It's about believing in yourself.
Believing in myself.
Yeah.
I believe.
And you'll get the power to breathe fire. This is radioactive hot sauce. How do you think I got my powers, man?
I never even thought about that, actually.
It's also like regular radioactive, not like comic book radioactive.
It'll give you a tragic, you know, story. People will like that, and you'll be have a lot of money for chemo.
But real sad and hate you for it.
I don't want to be a
sad boy. I'm gonna order you that T-shirt. Right,
sad boy.
Sad boy, because I've given you the powers to make your enemies just bawl all the time. They won't be able to commit crimes.
With
sad
this ugly
boy.
Mug. Which you were born.
We've all got our afflictions. I mean, my parents are dead.
I killed them, and yours are next.
They're villains. My parents were villains, and I want to right their wrongs. And
okay. Crying, smiling too much.
You know, because they were like two jokers. You know, like you don't trust them. Didn't work well at Gotham.
Oh, I think I see what you're trying to say.
I'm more of the Rorschach type,
okay,
like very zero tolerance.
Yeah, but I think I'm really ready to get started. When can we, like, go stop a bank robbery?
Right now, get in the Dorkmobile while I drive.
It's got missiles that make people feel bad about themselves.
They're aimed at you.
Because people really don't like it when you're shooting missiles at people, so it's like, you got more action, dodgy stuff.
Okay,
so.
I'm not quite sure the logistics about that, but
you're
I trust
simple.
You.
Hit that button, missiles will shoot at you, my problems are over.
Because then the training montage will begin, and I can, you know, rest up for our next spin.
Enough. Boo. Now you're a cripple boy, Mike.
Now you can be my tactical support, like the girl from Batman. I forget her name.
So I won't be, like, involved in any danger.
Yeah, it's
going to
be super safe for
actually,
you now.
Actually, the cool lab is the most dangerous part of my job.
It's where all the important work happens, you know.
These stalactites, you're going to have to knock them down.
How does that work? Because I've given you a pair of super legs.
But they only function if you're murdering puppies.
Evil puppies. They're chaotic evil.
They're fine licking your face.
With their poison tongues.
I mean,
come on, get to see that evil puppy. Don't let his big eyes fool you. Give it a power kick.
He looks like he wants to bite me or something, so...
All right, now that you've done that, let's practice on an actually evil puppy. So, the next game is called Dating Game. It's a fun game where, who's guessing?
He's Matt.
All right, so Matt is our lovely bachelor, or bachelorette, I don't know.
Your choice.
His choice. So he's gonna leave the room right now, and he's gonna try to find the true love of his life, one of these three. But the thing is, he doesn't know who they are. So what we need from you is a fun little quirk for Academy.
Can't see shit. Memory loss.
Believes in Morgan Freeman.
She can only see ducks.
Doesn't have bones.
Evil puppies.
Yeah. Everyone's voice to her is Morgan Freeman.
There isn't a god.
You are a robot. No,
consciousness.
You're gaining consciousness.
Self-awareness. You're becoming self-aware.
Okay. So now we need one for Doug.
He's on a never-ending scare.
He's in the last 4 years on an island.
He's a kid, he's a man.
Doug. You are Matt's arch rival. Finally, something for Ned.
He just
he ran a marathon on Stairmaster. Like he just did.
How's dramatic backstory?
Okay, so just to review, Ken, who are you?
I am a robot becoming self-aware.
Doug?
I'm Matt's arch rival.
Ned?
I dig my hair.
Matt!
Matt!
Light the beacon!
Matt! Light the beacon!
Light the beacon!
Look at all of you. Wow. This is just an absolute treat for me. I mean, I could just like flip a coin or like a three-sided coin or something. Whichever one I got, that'd be just like an absolute treat looking at the three of you. Bachelor number one.
Yeah.
Oh, my bachelor number one. You've got quite the voice. Bachelor number one. Radio broadcast with such a sweet voice then?
Well, I've never really thought of anything. No, you don't have to do that. Maybe one day.
Oh my god. Yeah, free expression and all that. You do what you're feeling.
What's up, babe?
Bachelor number two.
Yo, what's up, homie?
Are you snapping your fingers over?
Yeah, I mean, last time I was on a show like this, I got all three in 30 seconds. You gotta step it up.
Well, all right, I'll try and keep up with that kind of attitude. Bachelor number three.
Whoa, give me a second.
Not even a question. Not even a question. Oh, because I snapped my fingers, and all of a sudden better me. Always be better than
me. No, you don't have to.
Bachelor number three.
Exotic, I know, but...
Can you ride horses? I mean, with a head of hair like that.
Oh, I didn't think anyone would notice.
I noticed.
You noticed?
Yeah, right away. Oh.
You want to touch?
No.
I suppose, but yes, I have ridden horses in the past.
You have?
Yes, I have, and they have... very long hair as well, but I don't know, man. There's something in
there. Thank you very much. Bachelor number one.
Jump.
I got it. Bachelor number one, you seem a little bit preoccupied. I mean, I'm over here.
I mean, but I'm over here. Let's be real, man. Baby, I like your touch.
How do you like the touch of this?
Yeah, how's it? How is it, man?
I want to love. I'm gonna hurt someone.
Hurt him!
I think we're supposed to stay in our seats. That's why we're all here. Bachelor number two, what's your problem?
What's my problem, huh? Huh? My mom showed you more attention than me when we lived together in the cul-de-sac. So I went to a better school than you, but she didn't care then.
talk to him that way.
Locks, man.
Oh, it's all over me. Still not gonna sit.
All right, well, bachelor number three.
Yeah, baby, what's up?
I just get so distracted by it. I'm sorry, do you... You don't model, do you?
Wait a second, give me this.
Okay.
No, it covers it up. Never mind.
Make my sparks fly.
Oh my gosh. What am I doing?
No! I love... No. This is all so new to me. I don't know.
Bachelor number one.
I have choices and...
Bachelor number one. You don't have to hurt anyone anymore. And baby, if you hurt me, we'll figure it out. You don't have to be a killbot any longer.
It's all right. I won this round.
I get it. You're the one who's really playing the game here.
I mean, ever since we were little, I've always said, smell you later, twerp. It's all in the game, man.
I'm done with that.
Motherfucking Gary O.
If I'm the Gary to your ass, then totally.
I was not expecting my rival to show up. I'm surprised that they could afford Fabio's raids, because he usually charged
Fabio. Fabio wishes he were like me.
Right. So I'm sorry, are you the latest shampoo model?
I've been asked to do that before, actually, uh-huh. But you know what? I just feel like I should just have it all to myself, you know?
You just have the greatest head of hair ever.
Yeah!
You don't have to be a killbot anymore if you don't want to be.
Don't want to be.
If you're trying to figure out how to love, that's what this is all about.
Yes. The game is called Last Man Standing. This is for whichever four people are playing this game. Oh. Hey, four people. Okay, so in this game, we're going to have four people do a rather short scene, and at the end of this scene, you, the audience, is going to vote one of them off, and the other three are going to be left to complete the scene without their fallen comrade. How we're going to vote, this is kind of confusing. Say, I put my hand over Ned here. You're going to clap if you want him out of here. If you don't want him in the scene anymore. Clap. This is like not the other way. Okay. So I am going
don't
to...
Don't be afraid to clap. It has to be...
It's do what you love.
It's
love
part
what you
of
do.
It.
Okay. So I am going to need a non-geographic location for this one.
Non-geographic.
Hogwarts.
Hogwarts.
Non-geographic. Are in a space station. Lights up.
You can stop doing that robot.
Yeah. Okay. I'm sorry. I just wanted to make it clear that I am a robot. Yep. I didn't want you to get all scared.
The point is, did you bring me my space pie?
Dwayne! Martian thief, give me all your wires. Give me all
don't
your wires.
Don't touch my son!
Don't dare
touch my son!
I'm touching your son! I'm touching
take
your son!
Take this space pie and leave.
Freeze! You clap for who you want off!
I'm stealing the pie!
Give me back my son! Give me back my son!
Sexual jokes all the time. This is a game that is all sexual jokes.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah, dicks, woo! Line game. I need some random inputs. I'm gonna put them up in my noggin and get there. And we're gonna do sexual innuendos off of your input.
Hippopotamus!
I'm really getting like a weird like hive mind because I heard like zoo 15 times. So we're gonna go with, if you know what I mean, the zoo.
Why am I always shoveling the shit?
Ah, it's got my arm!
You win the game.
They didn't break my wand. It's in this umbrella.
Most of the forbidden section really come alive.
It's 3 inches, but there's dragon bone inside.
I expect a patronum all over the place.
I solemnly swear I'm up to no good.
Saying I should slither in.
So maybe one of us is the Chamber of Secrets.
All right.
This is fast. If you know what I mean, superheroes.
I came as fast as I could.
Fast food? Yeah. All right.
Look, I know it's not real.
Sorry, it's after 10:30. We don't do that.
Just how I like them, dipped in grease.
My mom was right. I will be doing this for the rest of my life.
Got $5 for a foot long. Seems reasonable.
Just hold on 5 minutes. Jimmy's got to pack the meat in the back.
You pay here, but you get it at the next window.
Can you supersize that?
I'm pretty sure New York State outlawed this.
It was a surprise in every box.
I heard porcupine.
Porcupine.
Let's see if you know what I mean, porcupine.
Baby, I've been pining away all night to pork you, sweetie.
You should consider shaving them.
Okay, don't worry, I got the huge pack.
Oh, Jesus.
You gotta find my fleshy underbelly.
Porcupine's like peanut butter, right?
Look at its cute little nose.
Change it.
How'd you get out of the cage?
Game of Thrones.
Positive for Pokerus.
Just wait till it evolves.
Kids get started at age 12.
Baby, it's okay. I'll press B in time.
Smell you later. I mean, use Vine Whip if you're into that. Are you a boy or a girl? What's your name? I think my grandson knows you.
All right. You put on that Cubone skull, I'll get the club.
They call me Professor Oak.